NASA is sending a mission to the sun. We're going to fly through the corona of the sun that you see only during an eclipse if you're on the ground. We're actually going to be flying 4 million miles from the surface of the sun, 25 times closer than the Earth is. There are some real puzzles about the corona. The corona is much hotter than the surface of the sun. And if you think about simple thermodynamics, when you get further from a fire, you get colder. So why would the atmosphere of the sun, the corona, be hotter than the surface? The other big question is, there's a solar wind that blows out from the sun at 1,000,000 miles per hour in all directions. And that's what you see actually in these streamers of the corona during an eclipse. Those particles get accelerated up to 1,000,000 miles per hour. We've got ideas, but we can't prove it when we're so far away. And so we've actually got to go to the source in order to understand how the solar wind gets accelerated. We actually knew that there was a solar wind even before we had spacecraft. And it was comets that gave us the big clue. Comet tail always points away from the sun. And the only way you could have that happen if it was something was blowing off the sun, moving faster than the comet does. It's sort of like if your hair is streaming out behind you when you're riding a bicycle and the wind is really high going to the side, you know, your long hair will head out to the side. So I'm one of the scientists on the team that's building the highest energy instrument, which is called the Energetic Particle Instrument High Energy. That measures solar energetic particles that are moving a tenth to or so the speed of light, that mostly come about during the really active times of the sun, coronal mass ejections and solar flares. My instrument is actually an electronics box here and three telescopes that are here. So the particles that we're measuring are coming in these telescopes in five different ways. At closest approach to the sun, we're going to be 25 times closer than the Earth is. That means the sun is going to be 625 times brighter than it is at the Earth. Things get really hot, but we've got this enormous carbon fiber heat shield that sits out in front of our spacecraft. My instrument hides completely in the shadows. It can't see 625 sun equivalents without melting. But this carbon heat shield gets to like 1600 degrees on the front surface, and yet in back, it's the same temperature as it is here in this room. It's about 25 C. And so solar probe bus will launch and get close to the sun, but not as close as we want. In the first orbit, it'll get down to 10 million miles from the surface of the sun. And then over 6 years, it'll use Venus to actually remove some of its velocity. And every time it passes by Venus every year, it'll get closer and closer. And so it'll work its way in to our closest approach, which won't happen until like 2024. It's a 7-year nominal lifetime. We've certainly got enough fuel for that. But in order to keep that heat shield pointed at the sun as it swings around, it's got to use fuel. And so eventually, whether it's 10 years, 12 years after launch, we're going to run out of fuel and then we won't be able to turn and the instruments are going to melt. And then the heat shield will just continue to go around the sun.